Coming up, if you're troubleshooting an issue and wondering whether the problem is on your side or on the Azure side, in the next few minutes, I'll walk you through how you can get a personalized view of the health of your Azure services, regions, and resources, setting up alerts so you can triage service issues like outages and planned maintenance, how you can get official incident reports to share with your stakeholders, and your options for architecting your workloads for the appropriate level of resilience. Now, service issues are rare, but it's important to be prepared for the unexpected. Our goal is to meet or exceed the control and visibility you have on-prem by providing you with fast, accurate information about the health of your Azure services. So here I am in the Azure Service Health dashboard, which will help you stay informed and act quickly when Azure service issues affect you. If you're used to using status.azure.com, you're not getting the full picture because it only shows major issues broadly impacting Azure customers. Service Health in the Azure portal, on the other hand, shows you everything impacting you, including both major issues and smaller localized issues. To get to your dashboard, go to aka.ms/Azure Service Health. Service Health will inform you about three main types of health events. Service issues are problems in Azure that affect you right now, for example, outages. Here you can see a test outage with information about the impacted services, regions, an update from our engineering teams, and ways that you can share and track the latest information. Another event type is planned maintenance. Planned maintenance events can affect your availability. So in this example, you see the impacted service and region, information about how that'll impact you, and what you need to do. Most of these events are performed without any impact to you and won't be shown here. In the rare case we do require a reboot, we'll allow you to choose when to perform the maintenance to minimize the impact of downtime. Next, we give you health advisories. Health advisories are issues that require you to act to avoid service interruption, including service retirements and breaking changes. In this example, we are removing easy tables and easy APIs from the Azure portal. We announce these well in advance to allow you to plan. In fact, I have a few months to take the recommended action in this case. Of course, we don't expect you to regularly visit this dashboard. In fact, there are two important things you can do to avoid that. Set up Service Health alerts and architect your solutions for the appropriate level of resilience. Service Health alerts automatically notify you about health events via your preferred channel, including email, SMS, push notification, and webhook, so you can know what's happening and take any necessary action. Before setting up your alerts, you'll want to think through your alerting strategy with your team. A few key considerations. First, let's start with criticality. So how important is a given subscription, service, or region to you? If it's production, you'll want to set up an alert for it. Dev test might be unnecessary. Service Health is personalized, so we won't trigger your alert if the service issue is affecting a service or region you aren't using. Next, consider who to inform. Who is the right person or team to tell about a service issue so they can act? For example, send SQL or Cosmos DB issues to your database team. Finally, think about how to inform them. What is the right communication channel for the message? Email is noisy, so it might take longer for your teams to respond. That's fine for planned maintenance that's weeks away, but not for an outage affecting you right now, in which case you'll want to alert your on-call team using a channel that's immediately seen, like a push notification or SMS. If you're configuring your first alert, it's fine to create a simple catch-all email alert for all services, regions, and health events. However, if your organization does use a problem management tool like ServiceNow, we highly recommend integrating it with your Service Health alerts so you can follow your team's existing ticketing and workflow practices. And I'll show you how to do that in a second. Back in Service Health, let's set up an alert. To get started, click Create Service Health Alert. The first thing you want to do is define your alert target, which is the condition that'll cause the alert to fire. Choose the subscription, services, regions, and event types that you want to get notified about. Next, select the action to perform if the alert is triggered. This will define who gets notified and how. If you already have action groups set up, for example, for your custom Azure Monitor alerts, you can select one of those and move on. Otherwise, click Create Action Group. Here you'll define which type or types of actions you'd like to run. As discussed before, options include email, SMS, push notification through the Azure mobile app, webhook and ITSM integration, and more, so you can tie into your organization's ticketing systems like PagerDuty, ServiceNow, or others you might be using. Finally, you'll want to give your alert a name and description so it's easier to manage multiple alerts. Once you click Create Alert Rule, you're set up and ready to go. Now you're safe in the knowledge that you'll be better informed and able to act more quickly if a service issue ever affects you. During an outage, we're committed to resolving the issue quickly and keeping you informed. Now, after an issue is resolved, you can get an official report from Microsoft. To do that, in health history, you can see past incidents and maintenance and health advisories. As soon as they're available, you'll also find RCAs under each incident. You can download and share Microsoft's official issue summary as a PDF. More important than understanding the impact of an issue is avoiding that impact altogether. Ultimately, the reliability of anything running in Azure is a shared responsibility we have with you. Even though we meet the vast majority of our SLAs, our engineering teams are constantly investing in improving the reliability of the platform itself. As you can see here in Mark Krasinovich's recent blog, this includes additional redundancies in our platform, quality assurance throughout our release pipeline, and automation in our processes. Now, on your side, there are things you can do to architect for resilience and uptime. Architecting for resilience means protecting yourself against different types of failures. A problem might impact a single host server or server rack, like an isolated hardware failure. A more severe problem might impact an entire data center, like networking or utility feed issues. Or in the worst case scenario, a problem might impact a whole region, like during a natural disaster. To protect against isolated hardware failures, you can, for example, use availability sets so that your VM runs simultaneously in two places within the same data center. If you do that, instead of the usual 99.9% SLA for single VMs with premium storage, we provide a higher SLA, 99.95%, since you've decreased your risk by running your VM in a highly available way. Now, to mitigate data center-wide issues, you can use availability zones, already available in our 10 largest regions with more coming soon. These AZs represent unique physical locations within a region with independent power, network, and cooling. If you run your VM in two different zones within a region, we provide an even higher SLA, 99.99%. Finally, to protect against region-wide issues, you could use Azure Site Recovery to replicate an Azure VM to a different Azure region, either manually or in an automated way once issues are detected. We maintain guidance on designing reliable applications, including best practices for architectural design, monitoring application health, and responding to failures and disasters. This has been a quick overview of Azure Service Health and architecting for resilience on Azure. Set up your Service Health alerts today at aka.ms/Azure Service Health and learn more about architecting for resiliency at azure.com/resiliency. Thanks for watching.